guys, it's Moz here from Moz6510 Models, and on the workbench today I have this vintage classic. It is the Handley Page H.P. 42 Heracles, and basically it's Rebox. It's been around for many years, and Airfix announced they were going to put this as a vintage classic last year, and now it's been released, which is really cool. Going on the history of this particular kit, it's only been released four times, so this is the fourth time it's been released. It was originally released back in 1965 as a red stripe sort of box, and then you had the 1984 release. It was then re-released again in 1993, and then now 2021. So this kit is 56 years old. So basically Airfix, in their wisdom, have decided to re-release this, and what they tend to do is rebox it using the original artwork from, I think it's Mr. Cross, you know, standard, and then they add a decal scheme which is similar, or you know, most of it exactly as it was back in the day, but they're made by Cartograph, which is one of the best decal manufacturers out there. So quickly, let's have a look at the box. As I said before, you have the original box art on the front. It is a 1 to 144 scale, and the code for this one is A03172V. That's A03172V, V for vintage. So let's have a quick look at the side of the box. One side you have the warning, and in different lingo, different languages, says there quite clearly. Again, you have Cartograph, you know, just a little sticker like that. It doesn't make it big, it's a little sticker there, or a little label there, logo of the brand. Side of the box, you have the box art again, there you have the code A03172V. Turn it around, there you have some information about the plane itself. It says here that an elegant four-engine biplane airliner from the early days of passenger air travel. The Handley Page HP 42 was designed to serve the Empire's air routes into the Middle East, Africa and India, carrying its passengers in some style. Okay, so you can read the rest if you like. Length of it is 195 millimeters, width of it is 278 millimeters, and there's 74 pieces. It is a skill level 2, okay, and there it says there you're going to get the Heracles and Helena, Imperial Airways, London, 1931. So it's a HP 45 Western. The colours you'll need is 11, 29, 33 and 53, and with this one you get 2 flying hours, because I think it's got a few more pieces in it, a little more complex, and it is a little bit more expensive. On the Airfix website, this one is going for £14.25, and they do have some in stock, and I'll link below to 2 places hopefully where you can buy them from. You will definitely get a link to Airfix, and I'll send you a link to another place where you can buy them if they're available on that website. So there you go, that was that. Nothing on the back of the box, but let's have a look inside and let's see what we get. Knife, whoops, trim and trim. The kit is a top opening box, there you go. So a top opening box, which is easy. You get one big bag of pieces. There's a little bit of glass in there, we'll have a look, and we'll place that down. There's the instructions, and also there that is the decal sheet. So let's have a quick look at the decal sheet. It's getting nice and close. There you are there, nice big bold letters, Imperial Airways London, Heracles or Helena. There you are, brilliant. So looks like you've got a couple of schemes there. Look at that, brilliant. Right, as always, a quick gander at the instructions, and this one isn't a booklet form, this is basically a fold out. There you are, wow. There you go. So it's kept the original instructions as well, they haven't really added to it. I suppose what they've done is they've scanned the old pictures in, because as you can see there's a very slight blur in the pictures themselves. And basically it's a breakdown and put it all together. So there you go, you put the fuselage together, there's your glass, which is very similar to the Concorde, you know, where you can, you got the little dots on the back of the plastic, put it all through, plenty on the rear end there with the fins. Then you do the wings, obviously, and then you've got what I call the A-frames. Moving on through to here, you use a jig to get, so they put a jig in there to make sure you get the right distance between the two wings. Placing it all together, there's quite a bit of a section there for all the struts, and they use the jig there again, so you to put the struts and use that jig, which I suppose you can move it up and down, so make sure it's completely level. Then obviously then you're putting on the roof of the fuselage, and there's the engines, and it looks like it's 1, 2, 3, 4 piece. There's the four props there. Yeah, sorry, two engines, sorry. Yeah, so put the engines together. Is it four engines or two? Yeah, four engines. Four engines, isn't it? Yeah, it is four engines. I don't know why I'm saying two. I don't. 1, 2, 3, 4 engines. Brilliant. And then, obviously, then you put under the undercarriage, all the added bits onto there, the rear gear there. And basically, that's it. And then we turn over the back of the page. And there you have the call-outs. And it's saying Heracles and Helena. So I'm assuming that they all have the same numbers on, and you just put in, so basically it's XAAXC is Heracles and XXAAXF is Helena. So you can do whichever, you have the C or the F, that's the only difference, I believe. So there you go, choice there, 13 or 14. And the colours are 11 silver, 29 dark earth, 33 matte black, and 53 gun metal. So there you are. And that's the instructions for this kit. Obviously, when it comes to these kits, they're not what I call on like a sprue gate or anything. They're basically one big sprue. And they just, you know, you've got the middle section and all the other pieces hand out. Just quickly go through here. And just drag them all out piece by piece. And the wings look like they're separated. There you go. And there's some more of the wing there. Here you go. There's the fuselage parts. Are we going to get this all in on camera? And then finally, oh, what was that just fell out? One piece just fell out then. I didn't see where it went. Oh, there it is there. So one piece has come loose. I can't see where that comes from, but we'll just leave that there for protection. And then we also have the glass. You can tell it's an old kit because of the way it's designed. So looking at the glass, you've got a fair piece of glass there to look at. There you go. Obviously it's easier having the backing on the bubbles, if you know what I mean. So you just have to, what I tend to do is put them in the holes on the fuselage and then just glue top, you know, just the two sides nice and gently. A little bit of the canopy there, but you're not really too much to worry about. They are numbered quite well. And there you go, looking on the back side as well. Yeah, nice piece of glass for that. So where do we start? Let's start with the fuselage. There it is. Whoops. Cool. Yeah, terrible. Here's the fuselage there. Nice big windows there to fill in. That's where I believe where the wing sits in. Some nice detail on there. Get close. There you go. Nice bit of detail on the plane itself. Obviously, nothing on the inside. A few little injector pin marks there, which you can either sand out or leave. I don't think you'll see very much through. There's a piece there for the door. So there you go. There's one side. And let's bring up the other side. There you go. Nothing on the inside again. Some more quite pronounced injection pin marks, but it is a 56-year-old kit. Onto the wings. Some nice detail there. All raised, obviously, because it is supposed to be raised. But I reckon you can get some nice effects with that. There you go, top and side. Again, injection pin marks that you will have to fill in. Some holes there, you know, location pin holes there, I think. This one here's got two parts of the engine, so you've got two nacelles on top. Some parts there where you can put the struts in. Then on the other side again, injection piece. A bit scratched, you can see some scratches on there, but it is an old kit. Only released 4 times as well, which is amazing. There you go, it's more of the bent wing there. Underneath, there you go, just moving through left and right. Again, injection pin marks. Plastic, quite flimsy. So, you know, Airfix plastic. A little bit tinnier than normal, I think. I don't think it's like the Airfix plastic we know, the softer stuff, but it is going to be a little bit soft. So there you go. Some injection pin marks again, you know, just cover them in. Moving through. So you've got the engines here. There's the 4 props. 4 props of the engine. Some struts there. There's some of the fins there on the back for the tail. There's the top, I believe, of the canopy. Some more parts of the nacelle there. There's your door. I don't know what that's for. Let's have a look at that. There you go, just looking through the wheels. There's not a lot of flash on this, to be honest. Bit of tidy up there on the wheels. There's parts of the engine. It looks like there's a cut out there. You have to rub all this down, obviously, to make it look good. There's the engine there. It's quite basic, really. But get a nice black on. But nice black, nice bit of silver. And then put like a dark wash on there. Really make that pop. So there you go, there's that section. Then finally we have this piece here. This is basically just, I think it's an injection pin mark, which is no worry if I need to glue it back on, but I don't think I need it. No, I'm sure I don't need it. It's just something for the injection pin to push against. And there you go. So you got some nice grooves there. As I say, it's a little bit, you can see it's tired. Don't get me wrong, it's an old kit, and you know, modern technology now, the tooling will be so much crisper and fresher. But, you know, there's tiniest bits of flash on here. But like I say, for a 56-year-old kit, it ain't half bad. So there you are. There you go. So there you are. That was an unboxing and a review of this vintage classic from Airfix, the Handley Page H.P. 42 Heracles. Thanks for watching. If you like the video, click like. If you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe and then ring that bell to be notified on any new videos. Remember to subscribe to this channel, it's completely free. Any questions, any comments, leave them in the box below. Especially if you're going to build this, let me know in the comments. And I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.